The Indian Police Service, Bharatiya Police Seva, or IPS, is one of the three All India services of the Government of India. It has replaced the Indian Imperial Police in 1948, a year after India gained independence from Britain. The Bureau of Police Research and Development is responsible for research and development of the police force in India. In British India, in 1861, the British government introduced the Indian Councils Act of 1861. The Act created the foundation of a modern and professionalized police bureaucracy in India. It introduced a new cadre of police called Superior Police Force, or SPS. Later, it was known as the Indian Imperial Police. The highest rank in the service was the Inspector General for each province. The rank of Inspector General was equated and ranked with Brigadier and similar ranks in the Indian Armed Forces as per Central Warrant of Precedence in 1937. Prior to independence, senior police officers belonging to the Imperial Force were appointed by the Secretary of State on the basis of a competitive examination. The first open civil service examination for admission to the service was held in England in June 1893, and the top 10 candidates were appointed as probationers in the Indian Imperial Force. In 1948, a year after India gained independence, the Imperial Police was replaced by Indian Police Service. In modern India in 1972, Kiran Bedi joined the IPS, becoming the first woman police officer. As per media reports, in 2016, there is a massive shortfall of IPS officers in India, which is nearly 19% to 22% of total strength. In the words of Amandeep Jakhu, an IPS officer, "We often hear that policing is a thankless job, where the good work done by us are often skipped and forgotten and mistakes highlighted. We are the ones who have to jump into the gutters of crime and corruption and emerge out spotless. We do not hesitate from doing this because police is not a job, it is a service. Hence, it is called IPS. There is no daily schedule of a police officer because crimes and law and order situations don't see time or place. So he has to be always ready to spring into action. A cop might be having a party on his kid's birthday or traveling to meet his parents when he gets a call regarding some major crime or law and order situation, and he'll have to cancel everything and rush there. To understand the life of an IPS officer, you need to have an idea of what all police personnel do. It includes crime prevention, crime detection, investigation, law and order duty, providing security at various political governmental programs, and the list goes on and on endlessly. Now, regarding the kind of life, it is challenging, because a cop has no schedule and he has to do things spontaneously at times because the deadlines are always near. Challenging because he needs to maintain a balance between work and family. Moreover, he needs to entertain politicians too. Challenging because people and media will say that a cop failed to prevent a crime that happened inside the four walls of a single house. Moreover, the force working under a police officer is understaffed and overburdened and lacks motivation at times due to the same. Sometimes even cops are not able to do things no matter how hard they try because crime won't stop happening. Challenging because rallies and processions will keep on happening and the duties police does keep on increasing. There will be times when people will point their fingers at the police, but it cannot be demotivated because policing never stops. There will be times when even the good deeds of a cop will be questioned, but he cannot let that stop him. Challenging because there will be times when people will question the honesty of the entire police fraternity because one of them did something wrong. A cop has to run faster than Usain Bolt to catch criminals in situations, so he has to be physically fit. A cop has to be able to sleep for only 2-3 hours for days at stretch, or have sleepless nights too at times due to ground situations, and then still be alert to attend the meeting next morning. Challenging because the cop has to be able to look into the eyes of the victims and assure them that things will be all right. The cop must have knowledge of science, forensics, mechanical engineering, management, history, geography, etc. to handle situations at times. A cop has to remember the CRPC and IPC in detail so that he does not commit any errors while doing his duty. Besides, he has to have the knowledge of every minor act that is passed by union as well as state governments so that he can prosecute criminals under the correct law and correct sections of the law. Now, a cop's duty is also satisfying because a cop has the power to give instant justice to an aggrieved person, and people respect his khaki uniform for that. Satisfying because no matter what situation has happened, be it crime, law and order, natural disaster, accident, civil dispute, any function, family disputes, any other emergency, people will look up to him because they know that he will help me out and the police will do the work no matter what it is. It is satisfying because a cop knows that by the work that he does, he is making the lives of people easier, even if his own personal life is getting sacrificed because of his work. A cop's duty is satisfying because there have been many cases when general public wrote appreciation letters to the SP praising the good work done by police personnel, but unfortunately, this goes unnoticed by the general public and the media. A cop's duty is satisfying because it is easy to point out the problems in something, but it takes guts to set those things right, and police has the guts to do so. We at Adda 247 salute the police personnel who work round the clock to give us protection and to uphold the motto of Satyamev Jayate. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.